Hairstyles of the Damned, which is the American English title, was my third book. And I imagine it as a kind of documentary. And so it had a lot of autobiographical elements. And even the structure's radically different from some of my other books, which have more of a epic or mythological structure. And for this one, I wanted it to be a series of small moments that accumulate in the way that a mixtape might be put together. And so that's an important object in the book, these mixtapes that characters make for each other. So the actual structure, shape of the book matches that object. The book has a lot of autobiographical elements. So it's set on the South Side of Chicago in the late 80s, early 90s. It takes place in the neighborhood I grew up in, and the character goes to the same high school I did. And so a lot of the same events that Brian encounters were based on some of the events, but it's fictional. I wish I had a friend like Gretchen back in high school. I did later on in my 20s, and so I was able to take different characters from different times of my life to build together to make the book. But it captures some of the same questions that I had about the neighborhood in which I grew up in, especially where it deals with some issues of race and class. And it certainly captures the way music changed how I thought about the world. I think the way the book works is really dependent on both of those characters. So Brian, as the narrator, he's searching, he's struggling, he's asking questions, and most of all, he's trying to discover who he is. He moves from one identity to the other. And Gretchen, she has already faced some tragedies in her life with the loss of her mother, and she's already come to some answers about who she is as a person. And so she's a little more strong-willed, she's a little more opinionated, she's more willing to cause problems, to cause action. So she's the character who most oftentimes makes the story happen, which is maybe why she feels a little more dynamic. But over the course of the book, it's really about their relationship and how they change each other and how they inform each other. And ultimately, when I think about the people I knew back at that time in my life, the people I knew back in high school, some of whom I don't even speak to anymore, it was those relationships, those fundamental friendships that had such a profound impact on my life. And that's what I was trying to capture in the book.